you have become more spiritual.
Just want to know.
Yeah.
There is a magazine called Jyotish Digest, which is released by SJC. It's a quarterly magazine on Jyotish as well as spirituality, Indian Hindu spirituality and Vedic astrology. And if anybody wants to subscribe to it or want some copy, you can talk to Sarbani. She's sitting right here. This is
the
lady.
Show you.
Can you touch with Sarbani? I'll also send an email letter with all the contact information.
Do me a favor, just open up that dream. Okay. Now, welcome back. And we will continue with our dream and we will go slightly more deeper into it. Because this sort of a superficial examination is not sufficient. We need to tell people exactly what is going to happen, when it is going to happen, what is the remedy, what is the way out, and those details. Right? We can gather a lot of details about the dream. Also, we need to know to what extent this dream will actually fructify if it has happened. Now, there are certain things, as I told you, there are certain basic rules. I have given this write-up to you. You can go through this and you can see that there are certain basic rules to check whether a dream has been true or not. Now, sleeping is what? Sleeping is darkness, is it not? Is it not a kind of death? Sleeping is a kind of death. In which it is actually indicated of darkness. It is darkness because you don't realize what is happening around you. But in a dream, you are vividly aware of as if you are living or you are seeing something happen. So what causes a dream to happen? It can only be the sun or the moon, the planets with the light. Am I being understood on this or is there any doubt? Dream or sleeping is like death. Every day we die and every day morning we come back to life. At that point of sleeping you are in total darkness. Darkness means you are unaware of what is happening. You are in deep sleep, you don't know what is happening. In that period, if you are still able to see certain things, like you saw a lion and a lion is chasing you, or you saw a tiger and a tiger is chasing you, that means there must be some planet which is throwing some light. It is like this, you know, like a projector. Some projector is throwing some light over there in your mind. Inside your mind, some projector is throwing some light and like a movie it is running inside. This projection or this light can only be indicated by either the sun or the moon, called the luminaries. Because light is only there with the sun and the moon. Other planets do not have light. Am I clear? Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Rahu, Ketu, none of the planets have their own light. Own light is only there with the sun and the moon. So that means, if I were to get the approximate time when a person had a dream and were to make a chart for that, that chart, the lagna must have something to do with the sun or the moon. If the lagna does not have anything to do with the sun or the moon, or the Lagna Lord has nothing to do with the sun or the moon, then you can clearly say this is just some kind of a vague thing, it is not a real dream. Either in the Rashi or in the Navamsha, the Lagna must have something to do with the sun or the moon. That is the validity check, that the dream is a valid dream. So what do you have to do? You ask the person, do you remember when you started the dreaming? The person will say, okay, I went to sleep, I had dinner at 9 o'clock, then for 1 hour I was reading a book, then half an hour after that I must have slept, and I remember sometime perhaps in the middle of the night I saw the dream, and then I woke up in the morning. Or maybe the person may say, it was such a terrible dream, the tiger was chasing me, I woke up and I was sweating, and then I drank some water and I went back to sleep. Now remember this very carefully, if the person woke up after the dream, and went back to sleep, the dream is lost. The dream has got no signification. The person must wake up to the day or should not go back to sleep after waking up. Going back to sleep indicates that the dream is broken. The results will not come. it is very important that to note everything very carefully and then draw a chart. Okay, I have already discussed these things with you. You can see these things. If the lagna is a chara lagna, the dream was long. If it is a fixed sign, it was short, like that. You can determine the length of a dream as being short or long. What type of a dream was it? From the planets in the lagna, planets in the Aruda lagna, the rashis involved, you can say what type of a dream it was. Shall we do some case studies so that you get the principles? Will that be better, or shall we go through the principles again? I think we'll do some case studies. That's better, so that you get the principles. Can we go further down? Just go down.
Much more.
Yep. Yeah. What's happened to this? Yep. Okay. You will have this dream of a Shivalinga. This is a dream that I had. You can see the date I dreamt it and the approximate time. I was in Delhi at that time. Can you tell me whether this dream was a real dream or it was a false dream?
Sun and moon both.
Right. Sun and moon both are in lagna. So it is likely that I dreamt it. What do you think I could have dreamt of? But do you confirm it? Do you think it is true or I was bluffing? Right. Jupiter indicates devas. Yes. Dreaming of gods is indicated by Jupiter. What else?
Moon specifically indicates Somnath.
Why? It moon in Taurus.
Yeah, exalted.
Okay. Okay. What else? Who else did I dream of? See the planets in lagna. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 planets are in lagna. And one, two are aspecting lagna. Can you see that? Can you see all that? Other than maybe Saturn and Mercury, almost all the planets are influencing the lagna. Shall we see the Aruda lagna? Where is the Aruda lagna? And the lord of this is again Saturn. So other than Mercury, almost all planets are influencing the lagna or the Aruda lagna. So that means it was quite a, many things were involved in the dream. Okay? Now, this dream was about a Shivalinga. I saw a Shivalinga, a huge Shivalinga right outside the building, and the other details of the dream are actually mentioned over there. Just before this page, you can see that. You have the sheet with you, you all can go through that. Can you tell me what are the results of this dream?
You saw deities, right?
I saw some deities in a dream. It was a very vivid dream. It has to do with the lagna means?
It is the ninth house. The deities are seen from ninth house.
Shall I draw that chart again?
Yes.
Our principles chart. Huh. Number one, I saw Shivalinga. Shivalinga is the idol of Shiva or an image of Shiva. That is associated with which house?
Ninth
house? Planet?
Jupiter
or Sun. That means number one I saw was Jupiter, ninth. Okay, then what else did I see? Pardon, you can just read that. Huh? I saw my wife. What was she doing? Wife was talking. Wife is ruled by which planet? Talking has to do with which house? Okay, then what else did I see? Yeah, Narsimha.
Why did you take second house? Second house is your daughter.
Okay.
Your wife is talking. Why aren't you taking second house as a reference?
Pardon?
Why are you not taking the seventh house as a reference and taking the second from there because it is the speech of your wife, not your speech?
Was I talking to my wife also?
I don't know, you didn't mention it. But you said your wife is talking.
My wife is talking. So I should take 7th house from the dream lagna and Narsimha's option is take the 7th house from that, and then that means I should take 8th house instead of that, right?
But this is not your chart we are drawing, this is a dream.
Dream, okay.
So whole of this is dream.
This is, a, I mean, am I giving any signs over here? No, na? Why should it represent me?
Because you dreamed it.
I dreamt it. So? So what, say I dreamt of somebody else running away from a tiger.
Because earlier you said something happens to your neighbor, you take 11th house as
a. So would that be a good or bad for the neighbor? But then for the neighbor again, the dream lagna would again be 9th from that.
Right.
So whatever happens, the basic principle is that dream lagna is always 9th from lagna. If I dreamt it, my neighbor would come out here and his dream lagna would come here. The dream lagna is in the 9th house from the lagna. We can do that. We can do that for the... Let's say I dreamt of wife. Okay? Let us say we were to make a chart for Sushma or for my wife. So I would have a separate chart for her. Let's say I had a separate chart for her and this I would do as her lagna. This is her dream lagna and Venus would be here for her. Right? This is as far as she is concerned, right? This is for wife. Okay, go on. We have a separate chart. My question is it not possible that I can see the results of somebody else also in my dream?
Yes, yes.
Right. This is for me. The results for me will be here. Results for her will be here. Second house action. Which house should it be for me?
What I'm saying is, the second house, in your lagna, what does the second house show?
What is the activity? Not the person. What is the activity? Person I took wife was Venus. What is the activity? I took Venus for wife. I didn't take Mercury for speech. I took Venus for wife. And then I took the activity, speaking, second house. What activity was I doing with her? I was speaking to her. She was speaking to me or I was speaking to her, either way. The activity was for me, Venus in second, wife was speaking. Right? I didn't take seventh house and other houses only. No. I'm just taking activity. I did not take the karaka of the neighbor over there. No. The karaka is for the person. The karaka and the bhava. Very nice question. Okay. Right. We'll just clarify this right now. Let us say a person dreams of his enemy. Let us say a person is dreaming that he and his enemy are fighting a terrible battle. His enemy kills him. Is it a good or bad dream? Just now we did a thing that if a person dreams that he is being killed, it is good for him, right? Did we do it or not just now?
Yes.
That if somebody is killing me and I dream that I am getting killed in a dream, it is good. We did that? That means I am going to get long life, I am going to have good health, I will have recovery from diseases. Saturn is going to the 12th house. So all that is very good. If I am killing my enemy then that person is going to have good health, recovery from diseases and all problems will go. See, I will tell you the effect. The reverse of that is going to work for me, since I am doing it.
Yeah.
What happens if I see somebody else doing it? You see my point? Let us say I saw that one Mr. X is killing Mr. Y. Is it good for Mr. Y or not? First tell me that.
Yes.
It is good, it is very clear, right? But it may not be good for Mr. X. Because Mr. X is killing Y, but X is not himself having any of the injuries and things like that. One sec. What happens if you become X? So it is not good for you? Get the point?
But how do you represent it in the thought?
Right, right. We'll just come to that. You are very clear that you are doing what? You are murdering somebody, right?
Yes.
Which house will you see that you are murdering somebody? You are getting murdered is 6th house and 8th house for you. You are murdering somebody is from which house?
It is the 8th house from 7th house. No, no, no. Depends on who it is. It is your enemy, it is your friend, it is who it is.
You are going to murder somebody, I want to know. I will not tell you who you are going to murder. Tell me, which house will it be?
So if you are murdering, obviously it is 6th house.
It is 6th house?
The person is the 6th house, so 8 from 6.
It didn't come out clearly. Mm-hmm. Tell me, which is the planet which will indicate murder or killing? Will it be Mars? Mm-hmm. Let us say you use a sharp weapon, Mars? Right. Which house will I place Mars to see that you are going to kill somebody? Pardon? 10th house?
You need a bold action.
So it's
Narsimha.
It could be third house, but my question is, the person is not you attacking somebody, but that person died. So would you take
whether the person died or not, we'll go separately. Go step by step, Baba. You can't put everything in one chart. It does not work that way. You have to break each activity into one separate small chart. Then only will you be able to come to some inference. Otherwise, if you try to put everything, okay, then I picked up the knife, then I took the knife over here, then I went over here, then it doesn't work. The whole thing will confuse. Take one activity, take the planet, take the bhava and try to get the result. Each activity will have a very specific result. Each karma will have a very specific result. Try to determine what is the most important thing that happened. You killed somebody, right? That is all. You killed somebody, right? So which house will that be? Seventh is the house that will kill somebody. Which planet? So if you have Mars in seventh house, will you kill somebody? How many horoscopes of murderers have you found Mars in seventh house? No, Jaze, it's not that way. Come on, Narsimha, what is the specific combination? Third? Where is the enemy? I didn't even talk of enemy. No, I'm not talking of enemy. You are murdering somebody. Which house?
Sixth house.
Who said sixth? Why? Correct. Guru Chandala basically means you are betraying somebody and killing him. Here you are just killing out of anger. So it is Mars Ketu type of. Is it 6th house? Will you agree with that?
Second or
6th, right? Okay. Will it be 6th house? Will you agree on that?
Second or 6th is getting killed.
That is the Navamsha. Will you all agree on 6th house or not? Mars in 6th house. Killing somebody. Yes? Right. Shall we place Mars in the 6th house? So is it good or bad for you? It's not bad for you. It's not bad for you. So long as the person did not die, if the person dies, then to this Mars, you add Saturn. And then there is a problem coming up over there. I killed somebody. So long as he does not die, it is all right. If he dies, then add Saturn over there and you are heading for serious trouble in your profession. The person should not die in the dream. Ensure that he doesn't die. If he is going to die, you wake up before that. Am I being understood? Somebody else similarly got wounded. So apply the same principle to that. If somebody else gets wounded or dies, he is actually benefiting. That somebody else about whom you dreamt, who is dying or such things are happening, is actually benefiting. A person, let's say you dreamt of a person, of a father. You dreamt of your father and the father was actually full of blood and things like that. That means if your father has a disease, he will come out of it. Am I being understood? So if your father has a disease, then he will come out of it. If your father has a problem, he will definitely come out of it. So you can, your dreaming, the rule that is to be understood is on this basis. About whom you dreamt will have good or bad. Okay? X is killing Y. Y died or not is a separate issue. Okay. You saw X killing Y. It is good for both.
No, but X killed Y.
Killed. And means the person died. That means it is bad for Y. X. No effect? What effect it has? What effect it has? Did you see the blood? If you saw blood, then put Mars over here. If you saw quarrel between two, put Mars and Rahu over here. X was killing Y. I mean, what were X and Y doing? Were they quarreling? Were they fighting? X was killing Y. What he was doing? He was not going to prepare him for food or something. He just put a knife in his stomach or something like that. So that is a bad thing. Two people are quarreling. So there must be two planets over here which are malefics.
So killing is always good.
Depends on who is getting killed. The person who is getting killed is going to benefit. So long as there is blood around and he doesn't die, it is fine for everybody. If one person dies, then there is a serious problem. Am I being understood why I said that? Yeah. Yeah, it does. See, what happens very often is when the dreamer comes, they'll give you lots of details. The tiger was chasing me and then I went behind a tree and then I went on top of a tree. You listen to it. You must be very patient. As an astrologer, you have to be very patient and listen to everything and then take the essence out of it. You have to take out the essence. What exactly happened? That is important. Okay, now we will go into what is known as dream charts like this. What is this dream chart? This is a chart which was made for the dream. This was a chart which was made for the dream. And I want to know, is this a good chart or bad chart? What predictions will you make on this chart? What sort of a chart is this? Do you see some kind of a Kala Sarpa, Kala Amrita Yoga or something like that? Kala Sarpa Yoga is there. So is it good or bad? Dream is. So there are so many good things also happening. There are so many bad things also happening. So what are the good things that will happen? What are the bad things that will happen? The native will have fame. Why? Why do you say that? I mean, on what basis are you saying this? Are you taking the dream Lagna to be the person himself? That is out there. That is when we on that system, right? I am asking you people to use this chart. My first question is this chart valid or not valid? You said it is valid because the sun and moon are both there. My next question is, was it a long dream or a short dream? One sec. Is fixed middle or? Long dream? Yeah, okay. A thing which moves will go a long distance. Charam is which is who can run fast. A fast runner will run a long distance. A middle runner will run a middle distance. One who walks slowly will fix, like fixed is very slow, you know, he is fixed in a place. Will go a short distance. So the dream will be short. Okay? So was it a short dream or a long dream? Short dream. What time did the dream take place? Around 5 o'clock. What time would be sunrise? So it was in the last 1/4. So I should get the results of this dream within a week to a month, within that range. Within a week or the month, results should start coming, right? Pardon? 15 days approximately. Okay. Okay, I agree on that. What kind of results will start coming? Yeah?
Probably some good things related to your dharma or father, but catering things like that, you yourself thought something, but it's good and bad things.
The good and bad things are both expected, right? Bad things are expected because of the Kala Sarpa, and good things are expected because of some very good things out here. Okay, very good. Can you exactly pinpoint what will happen to the person and what he will get? And how are you going to do it? Because the sun is in dream lagna? That's why? Ninth from the dream lagna is sun and Jupiter. Ninth house has got sun and Jupiter? That is the first and fine important question. How do you go about analyzing the results? Is it not? Firstly, we checked up the validity of the dream, that yes, this is a valid dream. What the this house has to do with what he dreams about. So, what you are dreaming about is seen from which house? Like this. This lagna is like this lagna. What you are dreaming about? The results we will see from the ninth house. Right? So, treat the ninth house as the dream lagna. Is it possible to open this? But I'll tell you. Just see Jagannath Rath. Do you have Jagannath Rath?
Yeah,
open. Open one sec. Now, do you see this chart? Can you see the chart clearly over there? Right. Now, what I am going to do. Hey, how do you see this in the first house? I mean, I'm just keeping the cursor out here so that you understand. I want you to treat this as the first house and see the results. Same principle we are going to use. Which is the ninth house? Yeah, that's the ninth house, right. Treat Capricorn as the lagna of the dream lagna. Results. We'll apply the same thing. This is the time when I was dreaming. The results I will get from here, Bhagya. Same ninth house principle. Use the ninth house principle and see if you can tell me what will happen. Yeah. Exalted, no, is debilitated. Okay, somebody, let's start. Come on, somebody can make an attempt, please. Yeah, go on. Saturn debilitated in the fourth house, so there is problems in peace. Problems at home, because fourth house has to do with home. Saturn is there in debility. Okay, fine. Right. Okay, what else? Anybody else wants to attempt? Lot of things in the fifth house of education and knowledge, yes. A very big focus is coming on the fifth house. Pardon? Yeah. Yeah, okay. Something is blocked out there with my son and that could open up. Okay, maybe, yes. What else?
Saturn is 4th of 3. In case you have to go home or change from home.
This is covering the period 2000 to 2001, right? What are the period? Just see the period.
This is
2001. No, it didn't happen. Nothing happened in my home. Okay.
Huh?
So benefic in the house of service is bad in service? Pardon? Yeah, satisfaction at work. Actually it happened. Within about 15-20 days, in fact, something very good had happened in my service. Very good. I had got a raise and things like that and recognized for some work. I was in defense at that point of time. I was recognized for somebody. Something very crucial, don't you see the 10th Lord involved in something? 10th Lord, Venus, can you see that over there? Close coming, can you see the degrees? Can we just go to basics? Can you see something out there? What about Sun? Do you think that Venus is getting combust completely by the Sun? And what happened? I mean, treat this as the first cause, why do you change it? No, you press the wrong thing all the time.
No.
Okay? No, show a chart from this house. Go up. I think I'm better at handling this software. I think I'm better with this software. Looks like you don't use this software too much. If you use it, you'll know exactly. This is very nice software. Very good software. You know, it helps you quickly. If you get used to it, you'll know exactly. There are so many features in it. Now you can see clearly. I'll just show it to you. If you see the degrees here, the Sun is in 18 degrees. Can you see that? And you see Venus over here in 16 degrees. Do you see the combustion of Venus?
Yes.
And from this, what is Sun? Sun is the 8th Lord. What happens when the 8th Lord and the 10th Lord conjoin and the 8th Lord is overpowering the 10th Lord? What is going to happen? 8th house is the house of resignation.
Retirement,
resignation. Yeah, I resigned from the job. That is what. Yeah, I just resigned from the job. Something came over me, I just said enough. I don't want. Mercury is not combustion. Right. There were some problems pertaining to fifth house also. Mm-hmm. Correct. What else? Yes. Right. So that means, would you say that I will take this learning to a very big level or things like that? Was this the year when I came to the US? Or after this? 2002, after 2 years, yeah. In fact, that year was the year I think I wrote VRA. VRA or Crux of Vedic Astrology? I think Vedic Remedies in Astrology, one of the big things I wrote in that year.
Yes.
VRA,
yes.
I wrote in that time, yeah.
Six
is what my... Yes. Why not? See, six is my working. Six. Whenever the 10th and 5th Lord are coming under a severe combustion, know that the power and authority is going. 5th house has to do with your power and authority. 10th is the work that you are. That is the government service I was in. And there was a lot of power and authority over there. So I resigned from that service. But my 6th house activity, that is Mercury. Yes, yes. My teaching and my writing is not coming to an end. In fact, I wrote a lot in that year and I wrote so many articles. I spoke a lot. I went around. I mean, I did a lot of work over that year. Related to Jyotish, I did a lot of work that year, in fact. And in fact, the work had become such that I just decided that no, I don't want any more of this Sun-Venus activities. What does Sun have to do? Government, Venus, one who is interested in social service and government work. I left that thing and then I focused more in Mercury activity. So Mercury actually increased. Yeah, yeah. It was not a business also. Was it a business?
No. But it is still free now.
So it is a service. It's a kind of service. These are services. Professional services are also services. Professional services are also services. You are still serving somebody. When you are seeing, see, the thing is, no, agreed that it has something to do with the seventh house and it may have to do with more a business kind of an atmosphere. But the basic fact remains that Mercury continues in the sixth house. That is, that writing and those things continue. But the fifth house thing is going completely. The power authority indicated by the fifth lord is going. Shall we see the compressed Vimshati Dasha? Can you do that? I think I'll handle this. See, there is this particular software has got this thing, you know. We just press swearing in chart mode and it goes there. Because entire, remember one thing, all dreams are to be treated like prashnas. The entire period is for 1 year. If you see, when you dream for the whole night, or if you had the dream at the beginning of the night, the results would be at the end of 1 year. So the maximum period of the dream is 1 year. The results of a dream you will get within 1 year. If you don't get the results of the dream within 1 year, that means it was no dream at all. Am I being understood here, or is there any doubt left on that? I mean, somebody cannot have a dream today and then have a result after 5 years. It's not possible. Okay. Shall we try? Where is the dashas? Yeah, okay. Can you tell me exactly when I would have resigned? Correct. I resigned in Rahu. Correct.
Yes.
Correct. In Rahu Dasha, I gave in my resignation. It was not accepted though. I had to go and literally get myself. Okay. And this was the time actually when I published Mercury. So you can clearly see that you can apply Dashas and all those things also, and it works out very well.
But you said that the dream would be realized in 15 days, right?
Yeah. Yeah, but in 15 days time, in 15 days to a month, in fact 18-20 days, I decided to resign. I mean, that hard decision I took, because it's very difficult to resign from a service like the ISLI or something like that. It's very difficult. In India, I mean, those of you who are from India will know that normally everybody will tell you that you've gone mad or something like that. No, I didn't leave India actually.
Oh.
I travelled a lot. I moved a lot and I travelled a lot. Yeah. But that will be within that 1 year. It didn't happen within that 1 year. It happened later, about 2 years later, 2.5 years. So that 1 year, nothing, no such thing happened actually. The moon and Jupiter, do you see over there? Actually, that was the important decision I took. That I'm going to start something which is very important, which has something to do with my lineage. That is Somnath, is the Shivalinga, which is the lineage. I belong to that lineage actually. And it's a Kula Devata and things like that. So basically it was like taking a decision to go in the path of my guru, that what my guru would have liked very much for me to do. It's a very difficult decision sometimes, but we all have to think and take. That is the Jupiter and Moon. Maybe it promised a lot of good reputation, a good name, a good and a good life ahead. So I thought of that. That's why. I mean, this dream was a very significant dream, because it made me change my complete thinking and I took certain hard decisions after this. Okay, shall we do some more dreams? Yeah. No. There will normally be dreams for things which are linked to the ninth house, like Bhagya, a complete change in Bhagya, because ninth is the house of dreaming. And when something is a very crucial thing which is going to happen, normally you will get a dream about it. If your ninth lord is helping you, I mean warning you about it or telling you about it, then you will get the dream. Okay, here is a dream of a lady. She saw Padmaja, that is our Narasimha's wife. She saw a dream of a golden colored snake at about 4 a.m.
She just saw or was chasing or did
Padmaja is not here, but she told me that she saw a golden colored snake at about 4 a.m. She saw the golden colored snake, that's all, at about 4 a.m. I did a prashna and I just checked up the exact date. She confirmed that the date was approximately so much. So I worked back on the prashna and I've got this exact time. I mean, there are other methods. When you do prashna, you'll know how to work. Anyway, this was the time. Could you tell me what exactly will be the results of this dream?
But you have to see color mood for the validity of the dream.
Yeah.
It's not in Lagna. Not in Lord of the Lagna. Sun is Lord of the
Lagna. It's a real dream, right? It's a valid dream. What else?
1 month, it will take about 1 month for the dream to be alive.
Why did you say that?
Right,
last quarter, about a month, yes. About a month, 2 months, within that period, yeah, you are right, correct.
Yeah, short
dream. It was a short dream. Why did you say it was a short dream? Fixed lagna, right. Yes, you just saw a golden colored snake. Now, snake is ruled by? Golden colored? Golden is? Golden color is ruled by the sun?
Jupiter.
Who rules orange?
Sun. Saffron is ruled by
the sun. Saffron is ruled by the sun. Golden yellow is ruled by Jupiter. So do you find Jupiter, that she dreamt about this golden colored thing and it was a snake? Do you find this Rahu and Jupiter aspecting each other? What she dreamt about has to be shown by the chart. See that Jupiter over there aspected by Rahu? So she dreamt of a snake which was golden in color. Right? The snake did not bite, the snake did not do anything. Naturally, Jupiter is in the first house with Mercury. I mean, it was not a bad dream. It cannot be a bad dream. Jupiter and Mercury over there generally indicates something very auspicious happening. Yeah, go on. Yeah. She'll have some gains. Why is she not going to have Rahu on her head? Because of this exchange? Will you apply the standard simple rules and see the results? What happens if somebody dreams of a yellow colored snake? She just saw the snake, so?
Tenth house.
Seeing is tenth house.
So which means that she has Jupiter and Rahu.
Yeah.
In
that,
which is giving you
Puri Chandra. Okay. But the snake was golden colored. It was not that she had dental problems in the dream. See the difference. That means here Rahu is beneficial. See my point? Rahu is beneficial in the second house, right? Rahu and Jupiter, Rahu is taking a golden colored hue, or the snake is having a beneficial influence on the second house. So what does it mean? It shows some kind of money coming in?
Yes, well.
I think that's precisely what I predicted. So your initial reading was right. That there is an exchange between these two for the results. And also, do you find this Mars aspecting second house? It's not aspecting? Right. You think she'll get some money? I predicted it. And yes, she herself was surprised. And that too what? Rahu Jupiter, not expected. It was not expected. She did not expect it, but it's come suddenly.
Did it come?
Yeah.
Can we look at dashas?
Okay, you can see dashas if you want. I mean, yeah, you can open the chart. Swearing in chart, yeah. Go to dashas.
She got it in Mars.
Correct. Exactly in Mars period she got the money. Very sudden. Oh? He'll get to know of it.
He didn't get the dream, no?
He didn't get the dream. It's hidden money, na Rahu. Okay, it's very sudden. Did she get anything else? What else could she have got? You think she could have got some ornaments and things like that? Take a look at the dream chart carefully. You think she could have got some ornaments? Yeah. What about Jupiter aspecting that Mars? What about where is Venus? I mean, the lot of wealth. We are talking of money, gains of money. Where is Venus? Venus is in debility. So, is it good or bad?
It is second lord in debility. Bad.
Second lord in the sixth is bad. Where did you read that? Second lord in the sixth in debility is bad. Where did you read that? Second lord in the sixth in debility in Marana Karakasthani is bad. Where did you read that? I'd like to know. So it destroys whom? A very funny situation, I say. If my Maraka is going to my enemy's house, he's going to... Second lord in the sixth, the person cannot be defeated in battle. There can be no better position for the second lord when it comes to battles. He will, such a person will even go to the enemy's house and get money and come. It is good. That means the other person, sixth person, will go to the Maranakarakasthana and give money to this person.
But how about his own house?
Are second, the Maraka is going into Maranakarakasthana, so is it good for me or not?
But there are other aspects of second house.
Let it die. I don't care. I must live.
Food
is already dead. You don't eat live things. Maranakarakasthana is applicable to living things. Yeah. No. Second lord in sixth is good. Why? It is in trines to the second, fifth from the second. Second lord in the sixth is one of the best possible positions for the second lord. I have seen the people second lord in the sixth or having conjunct second lord and sixth lord conjoined, they can be very good in competition. Very competitive. Okay, here what will it indicate? Will she get some diamonds? When will she get diamonds? Narasimha doesn't know. Secret diamond she has got, is it?
She has given it to order. Okay, she has ordered some...
Venus? According to me, that Venus is extremely well placed. And yeah, it's debilitated. So, even in debility, it will pick up and give.
But there is also Neetram.
Very good point. And it is with the moon. Moon has to do with gems and jewelry and other items of things. You know, gems and jewelry comes from moon. Ladies' ornamentation comes from that. That which pleases the ladies is the moon. I am quite sure that most ladies get very pleased when they get ornaments. It is the second from the dream lagna. The sun is the lord of the dream lagna. The sun is the lord of the dream lagna going to the second house. Right? Sun is the lord of the dream lagna over there. How can we say it has got nothing over there? I mean, sun of the lagna. Is the lord of lagna in the second house is the sun. How can we ignore this? Yeah. Fifth and sixth. I mean, it's a very good combination as far as wealth is concerned. Second, fourth and fifth lords are all over there. For Mesha Lagna, if I treat this as Mesha Lagna, the conjunctions of the fourth, Musan and the moon is considered a Rajyoga. Bhavartha Ratnakara, first line. You know, when you have the results of different Lagnas, for Mesha Lagna, the conjunction of the sun and moon is a Rajyoga. Wherever it occurs, it is a definite Rajyoga to happen. And when this Rajyoga is happening over here, Venus conjoining will indicate that she will get the benefits. Venus could give gems and diamonds. Okay, anyway. Well, my learning is that she did get a beautiful diamond gift from her husband. When was it? When was your anniversary? When was the anniversary?
September 10th.
When was the anniversary? Yeah, yeah, I got some. Okay. Okay, whatever it is. She's got it, I think. Anyway, she got some money also. Anybody has any dreams and we can try to work out some nice dream personals? I've kept half an hour for questions. Yes. Okay. Okay, we have. I have answered one dream question for you. I think others have a chance. Okay. I answered one. Pardon? You have folded your legs, means? You have cross-legged?
Not completely cross-legged. As if I have folded up to the top of my head.
Okay.
And I start rising.
You have folded your leg like a balloon and you start rising in there.
I have go above the three levels and like I am floating around. Not very high.
See, somebody getting a thing like that, okay? Last 15 years, he has been having this dream recurring. Don't make a dream chart. We apply that to basic principles. Basic principles, which planet will indicate somebody who is floating away?
Mercury.
Ketu? Mercury or Ketu? Here Ketu, more than Ketu, it is Mercury basically, which shows that you are floating in air and things like that. I mean, you have seen a list of planets I have given over there. Under Mercury, you will see that floating in air and such things have come. Go in and work on more. Okay, floating in air is indicated by Mercury. Which house will it indicate? Why?
Heaven is 10th.
Heaven is 10th? Okay. At the tree level you are just floating around like that. Okay. Which house is this? Can we have his chart?
Yeah, I'll pull up his chart.
Shiv, do we have your chart in this computer of mine? Okay, let's make a search, star dot shift.
Yeah, I'll take it, bro.
Thank you. Okay. So, you got this dream about 15 years back.
I keep having it, at least once or twice in a month.
You have this dream. So, the dream is related to Mercury, okay? That we have identified, and he's been getting it for the past so many years, 10, 15 years. In this chart, forget dashas for a moment, where do you see Mercury is? Marana Karakasthana. What else? So you are getting number one, a Mahapurusha Yoga called Bhadra Mahapurusha Yoga. That means it's supposed to give you wealth, position, a better life, everything in life. Anybody disagree with me over there? Please tell me if you disagree at any moment.
I don't understand why
we
have a chart because it's a
recurring dream. Right. It's his natal chart. His chart. So what I did was I tried to pull out his chart and try to find out what is Mercury telling me. He is getting this dream all this time about Mercury, right? About him floating in the air. Now, that is a very peculiar situation. It basically shows the instability. You are just floating in the air, that means you are not stable. So what is this Mercury? Do you see that Mercury is Badakesh in Badakstana? What does Badakesh do?
Unknown troubles.
Badakesh gives unknown troubles? Right. Obstructs what? Badakesh, it is called Badaka. Badaka really doesn't mean obstruction. I mean a direct translation is obstruction, which I have done a number of times. In reality, it is that which behaves like Rahu. Badakesh is one who behaves like Rahu. Now Rahu need not be bad all the time. Basically it indicates number one, foreign travel and residence. After getting this dream, did you come abroad or did you come abroad before getting this dream? After this dream. So firstly the dream started coming. After the dream started coming, did you want to come abroad?
Yes.
So it is only after this dream started coming that you wanted to come abroad. Right? See that. That means he had a dream regarding himself floating in air. Pull up his birth chart, find Mercury over there in Badakstana. Badak indicates somebody, someone who wants to go abroad, who would like to live abroad. Why does he want to live abroad? Because of Bhadra Mahapurusha Yoga, a better life. Bhadra Mahapurusha Yoga means better wealth, better life, better circumstances. Mercury, all the things that you can see about Mercury over here will be indicated by his dream. When will that dream fructify? Let's see. Pardon? Can we see the Narayan Dashas? Natal chart, we can see all dashas, right? And I think Narayan dashas give better results than Vimshottari. Vimshottari often you see, unless you, that moon is with Saturn, I don't know how much results you'll get over there. Okay, when did you start getting the dream? Will I say it is from 1990 onwards, 10, 15 years?
Aquarius.
Okay. And then Libra? It became very strong. Right? Quite a lot. When did you finally come abroad?
2001
March. Virgo, Mercury. So you started getting the dream from Libra, but you came abroad in Virgo Dasha. Aquarius, he started getting the dream, but he came abroad finally in Virgo Dasha. Right? So the dream of your coming abroad and having a life was something which was, something was telling you in the back of your mind that you have to go abroad. That you have to have Bhadra Mahapurusha Yoga will fructify only in a foreign land because it is Badakesh. Sometimes there are some very powerful yogas in a horoscope, like for example Narasimha has got a beautiful yoga of Jupiter alone in the second house. Very few people know the realize the value of that yoga. There may be four planets in the eighth house, there may be Dharma Karma Adipati and all that, but that is a specific yoga which is the Satyavadi Yoga. It is what you say will be the truth. Jupiter in the second house in strength is a great benefit. It gives tremendous wealth, it gives you everything. Everything you want will be given to you. You have to say it once. In a prayer also, if you say it once, you will get it. That great blessing, you want to see the chart? You can open up Narasimha's chart. That means the effect of that Mercury is still on him. Yeah, he has come abroad, but he is not fully settled. He is still floating. One day, that floating will stop. Then he will settle down.
But he should not fall while the floating.
Yeah, he's still floating. He's still floating. He wants to do his MBA, he wants to do this, he wants to do that. He's still floating. You see the point? The point is that when he draws, when he grows roots in this ground, the dream will cease.
How is Jupiter in strength?
Okay, is this Jupiter strong or weak? First tell me please. Is this Jupiter strong or weak? Yeah, planet in retrogression is supposed to have lots of rays and it does not even obey the sun, it goes independently. Keep that in mind. It can give very strong results without listening to anybody. Now in this chart you see Jupiter is there. Jupiter is also Badakesh. Do you see that? So the results of this will come only when the person comes to a foreign land. Narasimha had a dream long time back. When was that? 97? 97, 98 March, it has to be, okay. In which he dreamt that he went to a place and there were a lot of idols of gods, Balaji and all of them. And he is looking at them, suddenly walks around and suddenly all those idols come in life, they all become alive. Suddenly Vishnu is there, Devi is there, they are all talking to each other and there is a beautiful, powerful yellow light. He is suddenly amazed. This is fantastic. That's all. Is that dream good dream, bad dream, what is it? Pardon? Don't you think it's a fantastic dream? How? He dreamt of deities which were otherwise just stone idols. And suddenly they became alive and they start talking to each other, and there's a powerful yellow light. Jupiter, so many deities, all under the umbrella of Jupiter. He just talked of them as being together, so it must be a temple or some such place. They were just idols. The front yard of your house. Home would be? Fourth house. Okay, so that means this Jupiter would be in the fourth house, something like being in exaltation. Fourth house is a very strong Jupiter. It suddenly becomes alive. That means this Jupiter, which was dead till now, is suddenly coming to life. Yeah. In dreams, you see. We are all seeing dreams. Those idols were there, they suddenly became alive. My God, he's looking at them and awe as to, look at them. So what was the main incident over there? There were stones which suddenly came to life. So it is just about them being themselves, ninth house. Jupiter in ninth house. So Jupiter in ninth house from Lagna is being in the first house in dream Lagna. Jupiter in the ninth house suddenly gets activated, right? And I think within a month of that, you started learning Jyotish from me, right?
You formally activated me.
Right. So that you can see that when you study the chart in more detail, you'll get to know all that. Okay, we are almost at 5 o'clock. Now I'll leave this topic here, because dreams is a very very wide topic. I mean, I could go on and on, but generally it's important. Yeah, please.
You said you were going to talk about signs opposed to
houses. As opposed to houses? Signs, okay. I'll touch signs a little bit in this. Signs, the signs are extreme. The signs are, stop playing around, please. You can do that later. Okay. The signs are very important in any prasna. Because, in any dream chart, because here each of the signs signifies certain things. The significations of the signs have to be taken into account. For example, Taurus will indicate places like the Somnath. One should know the 12 Jyotirlingas, Rameshwaram, Somnath, Nageshwara, like that, the 12 Jyotirlingas one should know. So you can clearly see that I saw the Somnath white colored Jyotirlinga over here. Okay? Similarly, this has to do with places like where the cows are kept and things like that. Oceans and such things are seen from here. So the first house tells you about the nature of the dream. Then what I dreamt can be seen from here and the Arudhya Lagna, which comes over here. You see that? So from here, here and here, you should be able to describe my dream. Use the signs also. The signs are to be used along with the planets to describe the dream. Am I being understood here? Similarly, when you describe results, I take this house and the gains from the dream and the losses from the dream. For example, the lord of this house is here. It's very important to describe very carefully the results of the dream. Okay? From here, so from the signs and the houses and the planets I'm going to describe. Here Mercury in the sixth from here is in its own house. So this could mean a strong Mercury, it could mean writing, it can mean so many things. A strong Mercury in Gemini, what would it indicate? Like I was talking about service, my doing astrology service, my writing books related to astrology, would be indicated by Mercury over here. What else could it indicate? If let us say the ascendant was here, what would I have dreamt about?
Trees. Mercury is trees.
trees, but trees, Virgo is more right. Don't say Gemini trees. Gemini, you would probably dream about towns and cities and people and things like that. Aeroplanes, no, aeroplanes, maybe, yeah, maybe with Ketu, yeah, with Mercury. Could have dreamt, it's an airy sign. Giving speeches, that's right. Gambling, dance, but then I would need some kind of an association of Rahu or Venus or things like that, you know. Could be, yes, that's also right. The point is basically the rising sign and the Aruda Lagna will help to describe the dream. When somebody describes the dream in vivid detail, look for the planets and the signs over here. If they do not match, know that the dream is not going to fructify. I mean, if someone dreams of, let's say, a murder and things like that, and you find Jupiter in Cancer in the first house, tell him, forget it. Go home, enjoy yourself. Nothing would happen. See my point? There must be an association between the dream lagna or at least the Aruda lagna with the concerned planets. Because it is that planet which is showing you the dream. It is that planet which is telling you what he is going to do. Somebody dreams of a tiger, it has to be Mars. Okay? Okay. I'm open to further questions, or maybe should we? Till what time are we supposed to continue? Okay, somebody was asking about doing the some notes or small tips on how to read horoscopes. Yeah.
I have a special request.
Yeah.
I'm tempted to deny that request, but I don't understand how to read horoscopes.
There was a whole workshop done by Narasimha on this. Get hold of the CD and get hold of the thing. He has done a super job on Kashinath
Hora.
Yes, you will get the notes as well as the MP3s as well as the charts. So you shouldn't have a problem. It should be fantastic. I mean, this time I think the CDs are going to be very comprehensive. I hope so.
I have one small question regarding the confusion that we were talking about there. Venus, whether to place Venus in second house or eighth house.
Yes. Yeah, shall we try that? Shall we try to see? Narasimha, shall we try to work out on this and see what exactly happened? One of the part of the dream was, will this be right or will this be right? What result will you attribute to this and what result will you attribute to this? Let's see. From there I will be able to tell you which is right. It's good, is it not?
Yeah.
If I can buy a Mercedes, don't you think it's good for me? Do you feel depressed the day you get a Mercedes in your house? No. So it's good, right? So Venus in the 12th is good. In all general horoscopy, you will see Venus in the 12th house is given a lot of pluses. Is this good? Do you think this is a Marga Karaka Sthana for Venus?
Yes, yeah.
Well, I got some results of this. Okay. So, I mean, there were some problems and she was not well and things like that. She got transferred and, yeah.
So, we are just looking at the activity of speaking rather than speaking.
Right. Because everything is happening around me. I am the focus. I see my wife, someone is talking to me. I see my little kid come down. I saw Ashok doing this, my student doing that. If I go around taking each one of them, my son speaking to me, then from here it would be, no. If I dreamt, let us say I dreamt that I saw my wife standing over there in a big podium like this and hundreds of people are there and she is giving a big speech, then it would be, then Venus in the 8th is right. Yeah, go on. Yeah. I'll tell you one. No, it does make sense. If you try to understand as to who is the focus. see, the focus here in this particular dream is the person.
So you are saying that focus should be taken as the person?
Yes.
Okay.
Here.
Pardon?
No, I was the focus, is it not? I was the focus and the Shivalinga.
You are talking about taking focus as the Shivalinga was the focus. Why you? Shivalinga was the focus of Balaji. That's why I don't understand.
So fine, if I take the Shivalinga as the focus and the Lagna over here, where I would place her speaking?
That's the point, that's what I'm
saying. Where do you, would you be able to place her anywhere other than the second house then? I am telling, if the focus is the Shivalinga and everything was happening around the Shivalinga, then my wife speaking is here, Venus, wife speaking is here, my son speaking. Okay, son, fine, Venus is the lady speaking.
Okay.
There was a lady, forget she happened to be my wife, there was a lady who was speaking, then a little boy was also speaking, or what he was doing? Forget my student, he was a person, young man. Young man was he married or unmarried? Unmarried. Unmarried is ruled by which planet?
Mars.
He was doing what? He was what? Pardon? Prostrating. Prostrating is ruled by which house? Which house?
Ninth house.
Tapasya is 9th house or 12th
house? 12th
house. 4th house. 4th house doesn't even come into the picture. Either it has to be 5th, 9th or 12th, one of the three. Please tell me which one. 5th house, will I say he was praying? Will you agree with that? What else? What else did I see?
A lot of people pouring water on the Shivalinga.
Lot of people, public, was pouring water on the Shivalinga. Should I place the moon over here?
Yes. Yeah.
Other
people.
Go on. Yeah. Go on. What else? Because Shivalinga was the focus. Go on. What else? What else did I see? My son came over and he was trying to say something. He is not my son, he is Mercury, a small child. Okay. Okay, I should not get biased. Mercury, he was trying to say something. So should I place Mercury also over here? Was trying to say or was he speaking?
He wasn't speaking.
So he was not speaking. He was trying to speak. So I just saw him come over, right? I saw a little child come over. Should I place Mercury over here? Here or here?
One.
He just came. Okay. Because he just came, the little child came, and he was trying to speak when I woke up. Okay? What results will you attribute to each one of them? Is this good or bad? Straight away I can say that this is bad. Is this good or bad, 9th house Mars?
Good.
Good. Who was that? Good, bad is not, no answer. It was good, bad. That? Somebody says, do you think I will live? You will definitely live, die. What is this? What Jyotish is this? No, no. Tell me exactly what it was. And what exactly can I expect from that? Generally bad. Other detailed results you can find out. A malefic 9th house Mars is extremely bad. Extremely bad. Is this good? Does this indicate that I'm that the person who dreamt the dream is going to get fame or popularity?
Yes. Okay, now I have a question.
Yeah.
It does not show the focus of Shivalinga. Why are they your level? Why not Shivalinga?
Because I dreamt it.
Yes. Then the focus should be you, then your.
Because Shivalinga is already famous. Shivalinga is already famous. But I dreamt the Shivalinga. Had I dreamt you that all this, that Narsimha was sitting like this and all these people were pouring water over him and all, then all these things I would have attributed to you.
What you said is, the focus is your wife, you are
No, no, I didn't. Please, please, please. No, 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 no. Listen to me first. Please listen to me. Had I dreamt of you, let's say I had dreamt of you instead of Shivalinga. Right? Then the results I would have attributed to you. Now I have dreamt of the Shivalinga. Shivalinga is none other than the person himself. It is called Atmalinga. The Shivalinga represents the self. I cannot say that the Shivalinga is becoming famous.
Okay, let's say it's not Shivalinga.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like let's say I dreamt of a house and the house was full of trees. Would I say that the house is becoming popular and the house is becoming famous? No. The results will attribute to me, accrue to me. For the person? Or me. Right. There has to be an Atma. If there is none, then it is me. Okay. And especially in Shivalinga, it is definitely you. Keep that in mind. Because Atmalinga is you. Shivaham. Correct. Huh? No, one sec. What are the results? Fame, popularity. Have I got fame and popularity?
Yes.
I guess so.
Yes.
Lot of people hate me also. Okay. That's fame. Mercury in fifth. Do you think I've got scholarship? Mercury in fifth. Will Mercury in fifth give scholarship? Yeah, it does. Venus in sixth. Maybe some. Mars in ninth. Yes. All these things have happened in some different measures. Those of you who are in the email list would have seen this. So, you can see that you can easily know what's going to happen, provided you can dispassionately place a planet in a house. With little practice, get your karaka straight, it will work. Yeah. Can you just give your birth data? Can you give your birth data?
I have one question regarding this.
Yeah.
In your case, Venus in sixth, maybe Vana does. But in Padmaja's case, Venus in the sixth, they were on Earth. Five.
She also had in her dream chart, Venus.
We didn't make the dream chart.
We
made a horoscope.
Sorry?
We made a dream horoscope.
We made a dream horoscope.
We did not do.
We take another example.
No. That's a constructed. That's a constructed chart for the actual dream moment. Yeah.
If you take another example for similar thing.
You see yourself.
One sec. I'll just clarify. This and that which you saw over here are totally different, is it not? You saw Taurus rising with some five planets in it. Is that chart not looking different from that? We are not going to use what I purposely did this so that you take it out from your mind. Here we are talking of principles, and there we are talking of an actual chart. Okay? This is the most accurate way of seeing it. This is the correct way of seeing it. You will never fail. If you follow this method, you will never ever go wrong.
This is all right. This is a placement of planet, you still have another doubt.
Yeah.
If you see yourself die, would you place, say, your lagna lord or, say, Saturn, Oishkar?
I can't take my lagna lord, no.
Oishkar, Saturn in the
8th house. Saturn, in the 8th house, yeah.
If you see your father die in your dream, would you place sun in 8th or sun in 8th from 9th?
Basically, the dream is about what?
Father's death.
Father's death, right? So, is it good for the father's longevity or not? Is it good to see a dream about somebody's death? This is good for the longevity of the
person.
Read all these shastras, and if ever you see reading, if you ever read anywhere that you dreamt about somebody dying and that was giving bad results, send a copy of that to me.
If you interpret the result, do you place sun in 8th house or do you place sun in 8th from 9th house?
No.
Either somebody dying and within 2 months that person died.
Yeah?
Yes.
You dreamt of somebody dying and within 2 months the person died. When did this happen?
This happened, the person died in 98. I dreamt exactly 2 months, maybe 3 at the most before.
Did you know this person very well?
I know.
Was the person very closely associated with you?
Yes, I told this
person. Right. So it is very important for you to know that when you are passing through a traumatic thing, I told you in the beginning, and then you are dreaming about the person who you are involved with or you know the person very well, then such a dream is a false dream.
It's a premonition of the
It could be a premonition, it could be a warning or something like that. It is not a dream. The rules of dream analysis will not work in that case. Okay? I dream of my, somebody's son is very sick. And the mother on the same night will say, oh my God, I have this dream that my son is boiling and he is getting burnt. It's nothing, it's the mind that is working on the fact that the child is suffering. Logically, the mind goes into what is happening. That is, you are have an ability to see the future, so you work on that. Yeah. What was that dream about the scorpion? Can we do that?
Is it the difference between dreams and thought, right?
Yes. Yes, that's right. The difference is between a dream and a thought working on the subconscious level. What happens when we dream? Our problems which the mind takes. You know, there's a very nice saying, sleep over your problem. You have a problem, don't take a solution, sleep over it. Say a nice mantra before sleeping and then sleep over it. When you wake up, you'll find the solution. How come? How does it happen that you sleep over a problem and then you wake up? Because your mind has been working in the night and in the morning you have the solution. Okay? Now, shall we go into this dream? May I have your name, please? Vijaya Lakshmi had a dream about two scorpions, not one, and these scorpions bit her. Did you die, Vijaya?
No.
She screamed? Okay. It did not let you go at all. Kept on biting. Did blood come out? Don't look at your hand, of course. No. So which planet rules scorpions?
Mars
or Ketu, which one is right? Okay. Will you agree with me, everybody?
Ketu, yes.
Okay. And which house shall I see this event? So, would you say that this, should I place Ketu over here?
Yeah.
And there were two of them, right? There were two of them. Right? So Ketu over there. Yeah. Yeah, she is Mesha Rashi over here.
Right.
Many places you can see that. You have to study a lot. You've got to start seeing charts. Okay, now let's... Is this a good dream or a bad dream? Yeah? Who says good? You? Yeah. Notes in the sixth house are good. Tenth from the dream lagna, right? There could be something that is affecting her profession very soon.
Yes, reversals.
Reversals?
Because half of tenth is bad.
And two scorpions biting her, they are not letting go means what? She is trying her level best to save the job or save something or save a situation, but this is going. I mean, she is not able to, she's finding serious trouble over there. Right? Yeah? You want the job to go, to leave you. And it's a terrible job. I mean, it makes you slog it out. Right? Work, and that's it. Yep. Pardon?
That is the best.
The dream does not offer a solution. The astrologer has to offer it, ma'am. The dream, actually from this, if we analyze it like this, we know that, okay, she has a problem in her work and her work is in a terrible situation. It is very difficult to get out of this Rahu Ketu kind of things, you know. They are horrible, like those two Scorpios, they are horrible. And we need to see the chart and find a solution from there. But it definitely tells me that this is a tough situation. This can affect her personal life. This can affect many things. A 10th house, a terrible thing like that can affect many things. Pardon? Wearing the red color is one thing. I need a solid solution for that Ketu. Maybe a cat's eye would help. But then you need to check up this chart and see whether you can recommend. Another 10-15 is playing a spin with you, right? Okay, we'll go into that. Can we just see her Dashamsha and see whether that Ketu has something to do with it? Because we saw Ketu and her house of work, right? Let's see, what does Ketu have to do with her work? Third house? No.
Short term leave. Third house is short term leave.
Oh, anyway, go into detail. This chart has to be rectified slightly. Okay, so generally from there, from the Prashna, you can tell that you need a solution for that Ketu, right? And look for a solution from her natal chart. Forget this Dashamsha. It's not right. It's not right. Yeah, and find a solution for the Ketu and Mercury which you see in the 8th house. You can see that this is the 9th lord which is getting afflicted by Ketu. That is why she is getting a dream. Normally the planet, you see this, the planet whom we identified, which planet did we identify? It was Ketu, right? And you will find that the same planet is associated with her 9th lord. It must be associated with the 9th lord or the 9th house to come in a dream to be able to tell us something. Yep. This chart just confirmed that yes, she has had such a dream, and that Ketu is trying to tell us something very important. Ketu is in the 8th house of retirement, of giving up of a job, of just, she wants to lose everything and get into a spiritual life. Ketu is with Mercury. Pardon? Oh yeah, there are other details in the chart. Anyway, you can give a solution based upon that. Okay.
I do get this dream quite often. What is it? Basically, walking through a huge house. I actually discussed this with you during the morning.
What did Vishti say?
So actually, I figured out it should be Venus in the 4th house.
House has to do with the Venus? Luxurious house has to do with Venus. How long since you've been to home? Year, year and a half? Does your mother or somebody want you home? Have you talked to them recently?
Oh no, my parents are visiting me right now.
Right now, so there is no such thing. Okay. It could often happen that when parents are visiting or elders are visiting, you talk to them about home and things at home and things like that. So you could have dreams and visions about home, which is a but natural thing. It is very tough to call this a dream. A dream would be something which is like hers. Two scorpions biting me. I mean, this, it has got no direct connection to what you are doing. I dream of my... That would be a more true thing, you know. When somebody is visiting, it's but natural you'll dream about them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
There's this dream that I keep getting, that a celebrity has a crush on me.
Wow.
No, please
don't
laugh.
No, we are not laughing. I said, wow. I didn't laugh, did I? Wow.
No, that information is not a laugh.
Okay, a celebrity. Now, how do you decide who is a celebrity?
Moon.
Is he a famous a star? Which nakshatra? Why not Jupiter? Jupiter doesn't give fame.
Yeah.
Why not Venus? Could be a film star. Were you thinking of film star?
No. It's a
business tycoon.
Moon.
Jupiter. Moon is people who have got social success. Jupiter is people who have got financial success or success through things like, let's say, knowledge or very specific areas like that. These are people who may not be known to too many, but by themselves they have a very solid stand because of Jupiter.
And Venus is also successful.
Venus also gives fame, but it's kavya, more because of poetry and things like that. Poetry, singing, and things, a little bit of poetry, acting, yeah, things like that. Mercury has to do more with acting, you know. So I guess it's Jupiter, right?
Yes.
So Jupiter is in which house?
Having a crush in 7th house.
Crushing is 7th house.
Somebody is liking her.
So why 7th house? Why not 5th house?
5th house probably is a romance.
5th house is a?
Romance.
Why do both have to be involved? I like my God. Why does my God have to get involved with me? Panchama bhava is bhakti bhava.
Bhakti.
Bhakti is one way, it need not be two ways. Because I like my God, he must like me. No, you can't, it's not conditional. Love is not conditional, you can't put conditions. All swear in love and war. Physical desire. She said crush, she used the word crush. So that should come in 7th house, right? Or should it come 5th house? Was it a 7th house kind of crush or a 5th house kind of crush? It's what? I'll tell you something, you know, you people have got this, you are very confused about this 5th house and 7th house things. 5th is chitta, the mind. 7th house is very physical, very gross. The mind is not involved. So that's why I asked a very straight way, was it a mind kind of crush or a 7th house kind of crush?
It was both ways, I guess.
Should this be good? Should this be a good assessment?
It would make Jupiter in 11th. And even if it is 5th, then it would make Jupiter in 9th from the 6th level. So either way, it's good.
It's good, right? Because he is a good celebrity. What happens if this is a bad celebrity?
Well, he is being mitigated by the department of the
No. Will this be right? Jupiter is significator of the 5th house, Karaka of the 5th house. So even if it is in 7th house, a certain amount of 5th house matter will always be there. That's his nature. If Jupiter has to fall in love, he will still have that romantic bend. It has to be in the mind level before he gets to 7th house matters.
What good will
happen if Jupiter is 11th house Jupiter will give what? Direct hard cash. How? 11th house has nothing to do with hard cash. 2nd house has to do with hard cash. Why not friend? Why not friend? Yes, why not? No. If she is working for Microsoft and she saw Bill Gates, definitely it is not. It's not. Definitely not. Keep that in mind. To see that your boss is serving tea to you is definitely not. Okay, that is not a dream. That is something we all would like to dream about. Okay, but that's not a dream. So this is definitely a good dream. You know, to get dreams of rich and rich tycoons and things like that, indicated by Jupiter is a good dream. Generally, keep that in mind. It indicates people who have got the blessings, blessed people.
Astrological
Mercury. That's Mercury. That's very good. To see an astrologer or a good Brahmin astrologer, that's Jupiter in the 5th or 11th or 9th. This is very good. To see an astrologer in a dream is considered extremely auspicious. They say the sun and Jupiter would indicate or and see the level of the Jyotish. If it's a Daivagya level Jyotish, then it is Jupiter. If it's just somebody who is at lower level, it will be the sun. Either way, it's very good. It's very good. See the sun in a dream. Pardon? If you have dreamt of an astrologer in the morning, that I don't think that would be true, because I'll tell you why. Because you have come for an astrological conference. It is but natural that you could dream of some astrologers in the morning. See, you have come. If you get a dream related to an activity which you are going to do in the day, in the coming days or in the next 2, 3, 4 days, like somebody, he is going to speak on a conference, and before he goes to the conference, he sees himself speaking in the conference. So that's not a dream. You have come to an astrological conference and you dream of one or two astrologers who are going to be... It's the mind working out. Oh, the person was not an astrologer.
It happened that I was talking to him. Yeah. And in that dream, there were two men fighting over a woman.
And two men fighting over a woman, okay.
There's a good guy and there's a bad guy. And the good guy lost. And the bad guy is going to get the woman, but the woman is not willing to follow him.
He stabbed her.
Yeah.
And after... Okay, we'll just finish in another 1 minute. I mean, that's it. You can take this planetary positions down. These are the two guys, the good guy and the bad guy fighting that you saw. And Rahu is aspecting Venus, this guy chasing this one. And then this one aspects Lagna, so she could have got transformed into this. So that's it. Study this planetary positions and decide on the results. I'll end over here. Thank you so much.